Trust him.
Where it says bridegroom, you are the bridegroom, right?
That's right.
Where it says bridegroom. Put your joint.
His middle name too? No.
Which, I write Sheldon M.
Right.
Joan, you're a bridegroom, so right. Now, you have two witnesses?
Yes, we do. Mm-hmm.
Would you please sign your name?
An aunt and an uncle.
Preferably in English, or whichever way you like.
The last.
But they look Israeli.
The last line.
Take the last line.
They're not doing that to me because I'm female.
I don't do anything to you because you're female, but there were nobody else. In the, well,
how you doing?
Good.
Right here?
Unless you're
technically, I was. I can't get up there. You said I signed her.
I can show it to you.
That's what Peter planned.
Yeah. My brother in the business.
Okay. You'll, when I ask for the rings, you'll give me both of them. Perhaps by that time you're sold. Give me the two rings that I ask. Thank you very much. The ring goes on the bride's right hand, not the left.
Oh, right. Okay.
This is cool. Now, since it doesn't fit, you do not break her finger.
Just as far as it goes.
You hold it there.
Thank you. Cantor Lichtenman just sang the words of welcome. Bruchim aboim b'shem Adonoi be'rachduchem mi'beis Adonoi. Blessed be you who come in the name of the Lord. We bless you out of the house of the Lord. Standing here in the presence of God, the guardian of the home, about to enter into the holy bond of matrimony, answer in the awe of God and in the hearing of this assembly. Do you, Sheldon, of your own free will and consent, take Joan to be your lawfully wedded wife? And do you promise to love, to honor, to protect and cherish her throughout life?
I do.
Joan, do you, of your own free will and consent, take Sheldon to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you promise to love, to honor and cherish him throughout life?
I do.
The first part of the traditional ceremony is the blessing, first the blessing over the wine, wine being the symbol of good cheer, and it also gives everyone who is here an opportunity silently to wish you a l'chaim, that your union shall be for a long, healthy, and wonderful life. The second blessing gives thanks to God for creating the institute of marriage and for bringing the two of you together under this canopy right now. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidishonu b'mitzvoso v'tzivonu al arayos v'osar lonu v'yasarusos v'hitir lonu v'sinesuos lonu al yedei chupa v'kidushin. Baruch atah Adonai mekadesh amo Yisrael al yedei chupa v'kidushin.
Amen.
Israel.
With
this ring.
I do thee wed.
I do thee wed.
According to the laws.
According to the laws.
Of Moses and Israel.
Of Moses and Israel.
Accept this ring.
Accept this ring.
As a token.
As a token. Of my love. My devotion. And my loyalty to you.
As by these rings you symbolize your marriage bond, may their meaning sink into your heart and bind your lives together by devotion and faithfulness to one another, in mutual self-consecration and in ever-deepening love for one another. May you establish a home built on the spirit of truth, of faith, and of mutual love and respect. It is our custom to read the covenant of marriage during the ceremony at Selamah. Kol sason v'kol simcha. V'yechot b'shabbos, v'shivosur yom l'chodesh adar, shnas chamesh yisalot m'shva meis v'aboim v'shmona, v'bris olum l'minyon sh'aramonin kan, Stamford, Connecticut, v'mdinis America tzifonis. Echachosin shlema barab dovid, omlo d'obsunti yisrael v'ocho bas v'chaim avlom ha'kohen. Hebele li intike das Moshe vi Yisrael va noefalach va oker va ezen va fanish se sich lichin ki chus govern yu doim de folgende mokren de zonen un gefeinsel in shem bekushta vi hebele ich im mor besvahe ksav zuzi mosen de chosnachim in reisa un so neiche so seiche de sipa kaiche un meich va seiche ka or kolara mit zvis mos Yisrael va chum psuchta de vesli intike den yu dun da rosam be yavu be bersav be bezav be betachshiten Die Mann der Wische beschmisch hier und beschmisch da sa. A kol kibel od mir ab schlemme barat David Hassan da. Da Moses Israel roch was ab heim ab rum hat kein psut da. A kol mal der sie mir vorschla er der Mann der kostet mit dabei. A kol shorir ve kayom Yosef Yehuda bar Mordechai ei na Yitzchak bar Yaakov Halevi ei. This is to certify that on Sunday, the first day of the week, the 17th day of the Hebrew month of Adar, in the year 5,748, corresponding to the 6th day of March in 1988, the Holy Covenant of Marriage was entered into at Congregation of Good Shalom between the bridegroom Sheldon Katz and his bride Joan Bregman, duly witnessed this day by Bernard Katz and Muriel Lessler. This completes the first part of the service. In the second part of the service, we ask, but can we take the privilege into ourselves to take the cup of wine and pronounce the seven benedictions, Sheva Brachot, which invoke God's name to bless you with everything you could possibly wish for yourselves. The blessing of health, happiness, joy, mirth, exaltation, laughter, and all of the following blessings that the canto will chant.
Thank you.
What a gorgeous day today is. Did you have a minute to look outside? It's not winter, it's spring. It is so beautiful. The sun is warming up the whole world. And this day is filled with good omen. You're being married in a month called Adar. That's the Hebrew month that precedes Pesach. And in Adar, the Talmud tells us, Mi shenichnas Adar marvim v'simcha. When Adar approaches, that is the month in which the Jewish people should be celebrating. It is a special month of joy. But that's not all. You're being married on the 17th day of Adar. It's just past 4:30. It will be the 17th day of Adar for almost two more hours. 17. The numerical value of 17 is Tet is 9, Vav is 6, Bet is 2. That spells the word Tov, good. So you're being married on the good day of the happiest month of the year. That's not it. In a few hours, ceremony won't last more than a few hours, and then you're going to be sitting down and you're going to be having dinner, and the dinner celebration will be on the 18th day of Adar. 18 is Chai, Chet, and Yud, and it's life. So you're being married on a day in which you're starting with good, you're finishing with life, so you're in for a good life on the happiest month of the year. How could you miss? Everybody in this congregation is so happy for you. We watched as you were walking down the aisle, and as your eyes sparkled. Matter of fact, we had a hard time having Sheldon face this way when the cantor sang the welcome. He insisted on facing for fear he might miss you walking down the aisle. There is a very special love that flows between the two of you today, and it's good, and it's life, and it's happy, and it's joyous. And we all hope and pray that that is the pattern that you established today and in the first years of your marriage, that that pattern will continue over a lifetime, and indeed God will fill your union with joy and happiness and peace and love for one another. Now that you have spoken the words and performed the rites which unite your lives, we do hereby, in conformity with the faith of Israel and the laws of the state of Connecticut, declare this marriage to be valid and binding. And it gives me a great pleasure to pronounce you, Joan, and you, Sheldon, as Mr. and Mrs. Sheldon Katz, to be husband and wife before God and man. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord's Spirit hover over you, and may He grant you peace. May the Lord turn His face to you and grant you the most precious of all of God's gifts, a life of health and love. Amen. It is our custom, when we conclude a ceremony, to follow the thought of the prophet Jeremiah, who promised when he saw the temple was in flames that we would never forget the destruction of the temple, and he promised that at the highest moments of our happiness, we would remember that time of the flame. We do that by the breaking of a glass at the highest moment of your happiness.
Thank you. Thank you. TV.
Yeah.
team, guys.
Well, you know, it's kind of subliminal, advertising.
So touch your head and walk.
For the bride and groom, this word is the shouting cast. If you like him, like him, I'll see the dance floor, the dance step will stand.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, we need you all to be seated.
You just had a mozi made. I would like you to know that it's not official until the two of you eat from piece of challah. Now, some people know that... I'll juggle it. You have to eat from the appropriate part of the challah. Now, I'm going to explain something to you. If you eat from the left side of the challah, then the first baby is going to be a boy. If you eat from the right side of the challah, everybody knows this, the first baby is going to be a girl. Now I want you to eat this piece of challah, and only I know, but I will tell them right after she gives birth, which side of the holiday?
I hope it was a side.
Right, once again, enjoy your first course, which is about to be served. Ladies, check your wrist. Someone lost a tennis square set. is good play. It's out there, that is great. And there's nothing my play was going to drag. Raise your glasses.
Oh my God.
I need a glass now.
I know, hang on.
Let me get somebody to get you a glass. Wonderful pictures. Somebody prepare a glass for Alan? Champagne?
Mildred.
Nobody.
20 is mine?
You having a good
time?
Yes,
thank you.
Oh, thank you.
50 cents.
Don't drink it.
I'd just like to make an announcement before I begin. A gunman held up about 15 of the guests here earlier, and I have some good news. In touch with police, and the police have told me that they apprehended the suspect, and they emptied his pockets, and they found a couple of watches, a few rings, $35 in cash, and $4,000 worth of pledges.
Hey.
I've never seen a robbery at a temple before, except last year when my board raised the dues. And
give me another one.
Thank you.
The last time I was at a wedding, I just want to tell you, I was at a Protestant wedding, which was very, very different than this. And the one good thing I can say about it is that they've never had any roaches at a Protestant wedding. That's because there's not a drop of food to eat.
Ooh, right.
You got a point.
Not bad. Rib shop.
Okay.
Now, I mean, how much could one roach drink, you know? And at a Jewish wedding is a completely different thing, of course. A Jew goes up to the smorgasbord table, you know, like he's a partner in the catering business, and he goes up there, and he said, he looks at the thing, and I gotta have some of this meat. This meat is lean, it looks good. This meat is too fatty, it's no good for me. I want some hors d'oeuvres, I want them hot, I don't want them too hot, I want them cold, I don't want them too dry, I don't want them too greasy. I like this fish, it looks good, but I don't want it too oily. I gotta have some salad. I wanna have a little salad, not too much salad. I want some dressing, not too much dressing. It's gotta be on the side, and I gotta have a separate plate. Then the question of where he's gonna sit. He looks over, he says, this one's a mamza, this one's a kalyaka, I'm not gonna sit over there. This one I know, and I'm not talking to. This one I don't know, my brother-in-law knows him, he's not talking to him, I can't sit there. Why don't you say it? And, this one. Meanwhile, at the Protestant wedding, of course, the.
I know it's over.
They've had two hors d'oeuvres, six drinks. They don't care where they're sitting. It doesn't matter where they're sitting. They don't know. Let me just say, take another few minutes if I might.
Hey!
To talk a little bit about my brother, since it is his wedding. Now, I overheard a lady who met my brother outside, and she looked at him, and she said, "This is a Jewish boy? This is a Sheldon Katz? I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I just want to say that he is my brother, as much as this flies in the face of the laws of genetics, and we are, in fact, brothers. And anybody who knows our family knows that my brother was the middle child, which is a little bit difficult sometimes. Of course, I was the oldest child, and of course, that had its own pressures. And when I was born, my parents sent out birth announcements announcing the birth of their son, Dr. Alan Katz. My brother, being the middle child, of course, got a little neglected. By that time, my mother was a little bored. She didn't want to breastfeed him. She said, couldn't we just be good friends? Look, of course, I was no help in the matter either. I used to sink his boats in the bathtub, in the bath, and I see Joan over there going, when did he got so angry last week when I sank his boats in the tub?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Where was I? But anyway, I forgot where I was.
Toast.
Just sank his boat.
Everybody getting bored. Okay, well, today, though, I just want to say also that as my brother got a little bit older, I moved out of the house. I started dating girls, and of course, being the older brother, I gave him a lot of advice. And I told him to get a mirror for the ceiling above his bed, which he did. It had a little sign on the side that said, "Objects in the mirror are larger than they appear." Well, that mirror, of course, was a great triumph of a hope over reality. I always told my brother to make sure that you understand that there's two types of sex in this world. There's on the one hand, sex to love, and of course, there's sex to money. And just remember always the difference is sex to love costs a heck of a lot more. Especially. Today, my brother finally has married Joan. We met Joan a few years ago, and we've been extremely happy about this, and the Katz family is extremely happy today that Shelley and Joan have been married. The Bregmans, No, kidding, kidding. Of course, I'm sure they're extremely happy about it, too. And I just want to give you a final word of advice today about how things are going to be different today when, now that you're married. Of course, you realize that once you're married now, sex will no longer be the greatest pleasure. There'll be many more important things. I used to think that was music, but I found that if I didn't go to a concert for a year, it didn't bother me too much. But, of course, eating will become the greatest pleasure now that you're married, and especially because you're Jewish. And I think that it would be appropriate if you took the mirror from the ceiling above your bed and put it where it belongs, above the dining room table. And you'll be going on your honeymoon, of course. And of course, like tomorrow, you'll be getting up in the morning and you'll be having breakfast. And like any two Jews on vacation, what do you talk about at breakfast? Where are we going for lunch? At lunch, what are we having for dinner? At dinner, what are we doing for coffee and cake? Okay, now, I was thumbing through the Talmud last week. And I found a quote, and it said that a man who is without a wife dwells without blessing, life, joy, health, good, and peace. And I didn't realize that the Talmud had been written by a woman. And it's my sincere hope that their marriage is replete with all of these virtues. Okay.
Once again, your next course is about to be served. And enjoy it. We'll be back for more dance music. Thank you. up here at the wedding cake. Michelle and Joan are standing. They're about to cut their cake.